Greetings, Eric Bakker. Thanks for coming back. We're going to talk about Clostridium difficile, or c.diff, as people call it. So, c.diff is a bacteria that lives in the gut. The problem with Clostridium is it's an infection, a big infection that can occur generally because of antibiotics. In fact, I just read an interesting study that showed that there's one antibiotic called clindamycin. When it's given, it can literally, well, it's a big, big cause of Clostridium difficile, but it can literally, the study actually shows that it wipes out the gut almost entirely for 2 years, one dose. So most cases of C. diff actually occur in hospital, I believe, up to 75%. And also one of the biggest causes is antibiotics. If you look at the Mayo website or like conventional medical websites, they say that the cause is antibiotics and the cure is antibiotics. I mean, that's like saying, you know, watch out for handguns, they kill people. And by the way, if you carry a handgun, you know, it'll help you not getting killed. Right? That's almost like that kind of mentality, isn't it? So if you've got a Clostridium difficile infection, my concern is that you've got like a 20% chance of getting it again and again and again. So the recurrence rate's quite high on this infection. If you have got it, my recommendation would be to get a stool test done, a comprehensive stool analysis done, to see if there's any yeasts that are cohabiting there as well, or any other bacteria that you don't really want there. Do you have parasites additionally? What are your levels of good bacteria like? You've heard me beating this drum many times before regarding stool testing. So if you've got a C. diff infection, get a stool test done by a proper lab like Genova Diagnostics or Doctor's Data to find out what, you know, you're really dealing with here, what other kind of co-pathogens, you know, are you dealing with. That will give you a good insight into understanding what path to take when it comes to recovery. You know, what level of work do you have to do to recover? Some people recover that I work with C. diff recover really quick. Others recover slow. Others will get relapses, you know, recurrences. So it's a matter of really getting that information up front, so you're armed with that knowledge to know, you know, where you're going to go to. You'll also read recovery can be very poor for many people. They recommend fecal microbial transplants in some cases. And in severe cases, people get hospitalized and even have operations for C. diff. The key thing is there's no specific diet for you to follow for C. diff, but you may want to certainly avoid aggravating, you know, foods in your diet. You can again look at my playlists. I've spoken enough about foods and diets on this YouTube channel. I've done so much work in this regard. But to keep a long story short, with C. diff, it's definitely an advantage to be alcohol and coffee free, coffee and tea and caffeine free for at least 3 to 6 months. I would recommend the introduction of steamed vegetables or easy to eat foods. You need to work out what your gut can tolerate, of course. You may find it quite bad diarrhea or a lot of strong pain if you start eating salads, and even things like lemon juice or apple cider vinegar can be poorly tolerated by some people with C. diff. Yogurt tends to be fine with many people I've found. Even with the C. diff infection, they can tolerate small amounts of sour natural yogurt. Be cautious with kefir and kimchi and sauerkraut unless they're well tolerated. Protein should be fine to eat, long as you keep them on the lean side and not too much fat. Fish and eggs should be perfectly fine to eat. I'd just be cautious with the fruits. On the Mayo website, they say you can eat white bread, bananas, oranges, all that kind of stuff, but I would beg to differ in that regard. I don't think really white bread, bananas and oranges are great foods for people with gut problems in general. So you'll need to take it nice and easy, and of course you'll need to drink a ton of water, because diarrhea is one of the big symptoms of C. diff, and dehydration is a big problem. So grapefruit seed extract works quite well with C. diff for many people. It makes the gut stronger and it tends to clean the gut up. But as I mentioned, do a stool test first and then see what you can do, you know, in terms of the importance. What's the priority to treat? People with serious infection or hospitalized people obviously will be under medical care, so there's not much you can do till you get home. Fecal microbial transplant, or FMT, does work in some cases of C. diff quite well, especially for a person who's had a recurrence on it and wants to make a big shift. So that's one case of FMT that I have noticed feedback from people very successful feedback is c.diff, and that's what it's been used for quite a lot now in the States, I believe. So there you have it. Try not to take antibiotics if you want to prevent Clostridium difficile infection, especially as you get older. Antibiotics are not a great idea because your immune system is going to go down by default anyway. But you could really rob the effectiveness of your immune system by taking antibiotics too regularly. And it can push you into that C. diff pathway. And that can predispose you to colitis and a whole bunch of different problems. Many cases of people with colitis, older people I've spoken to, developed it after antibiotics. So there you go. There you have it. A plain, very basic diet to get you back on your feet again. Maybe some testing. And also a pledge not to use antibiotics again unless it's life-threatening. Thanks for tuning in.